share for their preferred medication, byproducts of their generation. Technically speaking, they were technical experts. The order of events on this particular evening of extraordinary consequence, underneath the influence of government-issued petropharmaceuticals, I must confess, remain somewhat a mystery to me. Hearing voices in his head, there's a haunting in the tower, and by order of the king, secret agents everywhere. There were cameras in the garden, helicopters flew the sky, the flower in your hair planted by the FBI. Well, inside information, despite this operation, a miscommunication must have triggered the alarm. There's something in your eyes, the way they glitter when you're high. Said this wasn't one of those times, and so I wonder why. Every time I listen to my heart, it tells me you were lying from the start. But so was I. At an undisclosed location, in the fabled age of information, paranoid, our super duper top secret agent is desperate to retire. When a flash lit up the wire, your assistance is officially requested and required. Without hesitation, commence operation, procure all necessary proper medications. There's a problem with the patient, and to be in operation, in the spirit of cooperation, I made my preparations. I have acid, I have need, it was an excellent time indeed, undone in the end by the most wonderful mescaline. I sampled it again and again and again, henceforth to be known as the mescaline incident. Trouble began days before I moved in, when a man was murdered across the street on the corner in the most depraved sort of way. It was not a good sign, and certainly not a good time to go fooling with such a haphazard and unpredictable thing as my own mind. What could I have been thinking? Having my sugar and eating it too. It was delicious, delirious time, and all of it without you. Till when at last you caught up with me, I was already, all wrapped up in the most improbable series of highly unlikely coincidences, only more likely to the aforementioned hallucinogens and some half-baked international conspiracy to put acid in the sugar and the sugar in my tea. Am I crazy? Is it me? Or did somebody put sugar in my tea? It's like this. I like trips. I love tripping. Yep, I love sugar. It's like this. I like trips. I love tripping. Yep, I love sugar. There were letters of intention. There were statements of denial. 4:20 early morning when the call came down the line. Without hesitation, without reservation, consume all remaining and proper medications. Well, faster than you could say, don't drink the tea. Regrettably, I did it with the whole world watching me. At that very moment, my life became digitized. You were playing with the lights and I began to feel hypnotized. You had X-ray vision eyes and you were trying to read my mind. The manner of suggestion in your questions, the deception misapplied. Everyone was there and everything was wired. All the lines were tested and all the lies were tired. Truly desperate measures for truly desperate times. The moment of truth had finally arrived. And by my calculation, there was something in the air. There was acid in the sugar, there was sugar in my tea. It was bittersweet and sugary. Then came the third degree. I was ready, I was waiting. I've been watching you, watching me. It's like this. I like trips, I love tripping, yeah, I love sugar. It's like this. I like trips, I love tripping, yeah, I love sugar. It's like this. I like trips, I love tripping, yeah, I love sugar. It's like this. I like trips, I love tripping, yeah, I love sugar. Hour of testing, I tried for his life, overdosed, under fire, and just completely exposed. Our favorite chemical technician, the very definition of a man on a mission, himself the accomplished liar, with only his wish to save him. These damaged at best and sabotaged at that, senses a trap, and reaching deep, deep, deep into the well in what is sure to become known as a legendary performance in the literature of anti-interrogation operations, slowly turns it back with a message for the king, and in his warble of a voice begins to sing. Lately I've been wondering, is it my imagination? Am I crazy? Is it me? Or did somebody put sugar in my tea? Sugar in the trees, something in the eats. Am I crazy? Is it me? Or did somebody put sugar in my tea? Thus began the acid chronicles. It was a troubled time in the muddled mind of a not so very famous so-called international DJ, who at this particular moment was perched somewhat precariously and precipitously on the balcony on a chair atop a table, slowly going crazy, saying, it's like this, I like chips, I love chipping, yep, I love sugar, bit by bit, I eat my chip, I love chipping, yep, I love sugar, 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 sugar. I like trips, I love chipping, yep, I love sugar.